live from the Rant Radio Network.
You're listening to Real Estate Rant with your host, Alex Alanis, and my co-host,
Miss Lisa Lombardi. No problem, just solutions for real estate needs.
Hot topics and controversial chat. We are back here at the Real Estate Rant, here at the towers of the Rant Radio Network. I'm your host, Mr. Alex Alanis, and to my left here, Miss Lisa Lombardi. How are you, young lady?
I'm doing great. How are you?
Oh, you know, just making the rounds.
I know. Same with me. I know it's been a while. I missed last show.
Oh, you weren't. Who was here last
week? I think, God, someone, I can't even think. Jesse. Jesse was here.
Oh, Jesse took your place.
Yes,
that's right.
He took my place.
He was our interim guest. Did a good job, by the way.
That's what I heard.
Thank you for joining us here at the Real Estate Rant, here at the Towers of the Rant Radio Network. Give us a call at 855-693-4897, or you can email us at realestaterantradio@gmail.com. And I believe Lisa would like a moment.
No, I you know, I think what I want to say is that, and you know, how can I say this? It's kind of an emotional.
Please.
You know, my dad has cancer, and he's not doing very well. So that's why I was gone from the last show.
What kind of cancer is it, Lisa?
He has GIST.
What is that?
And GIST is an intestinal cancer.
Oh.
So, unfortunately, you know, he's not doing well at all, but, you know, I believe in miracles, and I know that God definitely has a plan for all of us. And I feel, you know, I think sometimes when you look at so much negativity, and I know that we don't want to lose our loved ones, but I think what I've really learned out of this whole thing is that I am so fortunate and so grateful that I had a father in my life, you know,
because
so many people don't have fathers, and I truly believe that fathers are so special, and he was so special to me, and I feel very fortunate. And I'm also fortunate that I have a great brother and sister, Liza and Paul, and my other brother Lance, that have been just phenomenal.
Well, what's your father's name?
Angelo.
Oh, okay.
Yes, Angelo. He was here at the show.
He's,
remember?
He's Lombardi.
Yeah,
he's,
Lombardi.
Okay,
yeah.
Right on. He was here sitting on the show one time, and he sat in, and he used to paint.
Yes, yes. He was a painter contractor, and now my brother's taking over. So, I guess I just wanted to say that, you know, that I think in life that sometimes that, you know, we can't focus on the negative. We got to focus on the positive and feel very fortunate and grateful for what we have. And I really, truly believe that I'm like right now, I'm leaving tomorrow to see my father, is like, I just want to enjoy moments with people. And I think sometimes you have to take a moment and just, you know, take a couple breaths and, you know, and just enjoy life.
Well, Mr. Lombardi, we hope you get better, and we hope you're listening to the show. Thank you, Lisa, for that.
Yes, thank you.
Too bad we don't have a picture when we could put up.
I know. Well, next time we'll do that crazy Italian man there.
Right on. In house today, we have Mr. Kaya Redford, Master Certified Trainers for NLP Success Coaching, and Veronica, and I'm sorry, let me see if I'm saying this name right. Let's do a quick mic check. Is it Lira?
Larrea,
okay. Global like strategist, that. Master Ooh. Real estate coaches in the house today. So we have a good show in store for you today. Give us a call, 855-693-4897. Real Estate Rant Radio and AGR and Associates would like to mention Mount Sierra College, located at 101 East Huntington Drive, Monrovia, California, 91016. Their motto, collaborate, innovate, and transform. Mm-hmm. For Mr. Pataloni's. There you go, sir. We'll put a plug in for
them. We all need that.
Yes, yes. Yes, let's throw up the design deal, Mr. Pataloni's, if you will. Give us a call at 855-693-4897. You can win a $25 gift card to Stevens Steakhouse, located in the City of Commerce. Compliments of Eddie Tafoya and the Commerce Industrial Council, also sponsored by Said Corp, bringing smart alternatives to sellers. Fix your house before you sell it. So if you get this particular design, and Pataloni's, we lost it there. If you get this particular design, if you call in, it is a multiple choice. You can cheat on Wikipedia, compliments of. And if you get this particular design, I believe these are in Japan, if I remember correctly.
God, so, I haven't seen this one, Alex.
So, Veronica and Kaya, if you know the answer, please don't blurt it out, because you can't win a $25 gift card. I have had guests do that before in the past, right? So, anyway, Miss Lisa takes care of our questions. If you have a question for myself, Lisa, Kaya, or Veronica, you can give us a call at that number. You can email us at realestaterantradio@gmail.com, and we will try to get to those questions on subsequent shows. What did we get for last week, Lisa?
Okay, well, I have a question here, and God, this is kind of a tricky question here. It says, my neighbor says, is it legal for him and his kids to go on my roof because it's considered public highway? Is that correct?
Oh my goodness.
Where did this person
go? What do you think, guys? You think it's,
why
it's,
would they want to do that, first of all?
The question is it legal?
Yeah, is it legal?
I mean, just a quick answer. I think it's trespassing.
What do you guys think? I would think
well,
it would
be. Well, in
the
real estate industry, we might say that it is 100% trespassing. Without the authorization of the owner or the landlord or the tenant, no other person can just come in and just invade. That would be pretty much invading the privacy of whoever's occupying the property.
Yeah, I know a lot of cats that like to trespass.
Yeah. No, but I definitely agree with that, Veronica. No, absolutely.
Yeah. So
what do you think?
Well, I mean, just the quick and honest answer, just trespass. But I will say we're not attorneys or CPAs, so please consult your attorneys. The opinions on this show are not legal counsel. Got to throw the disclaimer out there. Just because, you know, we are conversing about this stuff and we like to try to answer these questions. But to the listener, definitely trespassing. It is not a legal highway. Your roof is not a legal highway.
No.
Matter of fact, it is my understanding that when you buy a piece of property, that you own it from the property lines to the core of the earth and into the heavens. That's mm-hmm. I think that's how it's how
correct.
It is.
Correct. Mm-hmm. That's called the setbacks. So from the setback from where the sewer line is into your property, all the way from the setback to the lot, based on the surveying, that belongs to the owner in title and everything else.
Yeah, and the only way to infringe those is through easement or encroachment.
Correct.
And typical easements would be air rights, like for planes, helicopters.
Yes.
Cats, you know, that kind of thing. Right? So what else did we get, Lise?
Okay, I got someone. Her name is Dana from Mission Viejo. She says she bought a PUD as is, discovered black mold in the walls caused by a previous leak. Is the seller responsible to pay for the removal?
Slippery slope.
That's pretty.
What do you think, guys?
Pretty tricky.
Yeah.
What do you think on
that?
We
don't have any more details, right?
No, that's it. That's all she put.
Kai's shaking your head.
Very technical questions.
It is technical.
I know.
Well, just off the hip, though, just as a layman, what do you think?
I have just absolutely no idea.
Okay. Veronica?
Well, without knowing any details, let's say the transaction closed yesterday. And the majority of transactions, we have what is called an as-is condition disclaimer. And prior to that, during the transaction, you have due diligences for the new homeowner to purchase. They go through two different types of reports. Natural hazard disclosure, which will give them pretty much the parameters of where the property is located, whether it's on flood or not. But in this case, it has to do with mold. So mold, unfortunately, is not discovered with any of the reports, including the physical inspection. The physical inspection will give the details as far as the plumbing, if it's in working conditions, the switches, if the switches have electricity or not, if there's any roof leaking, and so on and so forth. But going deep into what's behind the painting, what's behind the walls, the stucco, it's very hard for any report to show. Now, we don't know exactly, you know, she is already assuming that it's mold, but unless you are a mold expert with a license, one can assume that it could be something else.
No.
Yes, well said.
Yeah. Definitely well said.
We have talked about this on the show previously.
Yes. Vincent, and we actually, Vincent
Attardo,
yeah.
He was an environmental expert, what have mm-hmm. you. And we talked about a French term called caveat emptor, which in real estate land is buyer beware. And we do, the seller does have disclosure laws in the state of California, assuming that the property's in California.
Yes.
Unfortunately, to the seller, what it sounds like is it wasn't apparent to any visual inspection. In other words, going into the
correct.
Property, you can't see it. She's talking about it being in the walls. So you open up the walls, well, yeah, you're going to find some things, right? So how does the seller know that that stuff is there? Well, they don't. So is the seller liable at that junction, right? So then it becomes a responsibility really of the buyer to do their appropriate inspections. And can you bring Vincent in to do an inspection on the property? Absolutely. They can
yes.
bring in 100 different people if they want. So, you know, that's a sticky question. You know, I almost can't even answer it directly.
Well, especially too, if you can't see it, like you said.
And
you know,
the rule of thumb is for any buyer or seller is once the escrow is officially closed, which means the record of the grand deed has been in the court, you're pretty much responsible for everything and anything that happens into the property.
Yeah.
So my recommendation to this particular buyer will be to hire a mold expert that specializes and is licensed to do in the state of California, because there's so many inspectors out there with license that can say that they do mold when in fact that they don't. I have, you know, one scenario where one family hired a termite inspection to do a mold inspection. Well, that's totally different. So we want to make sure that this particular buyer does the due diligences and make sure that it's licensed to do mold, strictly mold in the state of California. Once the discovery comes that the report is positive, then there's so many remedies to get rid of the mold. It just depends. I mean, there's so many types of mold. You know, you guys are aware of.
Yes. And that's what Vincent was talking about,
too. The other part of all of this is on the RPA, on the purchase contract,
yes,
there is a clause in there that's called the as-is clause. And the as-is clause talks about the buyer now buying the property as-is. So once they're satisfied with their inspections, you know, but this is something that wasn't revealed to them. So this is where it becomes kind of a gray area.
Sure.
So I would definitely, on this one, I would say consult an attorney, you know, and definitely get your inspections.
Well, right? And did they get an inspection as well, too? Yes. You know, you're kind of wondering, like, did they get an inspection?
But how do you inspect the inside of a wall?
No, you don't. But like, for instance, like sometimes, like if, I mean, unfortunately, there is inspectors that do miss certain things, and maybe he didn't. You know, like, for instance, let's say it was underneath the sink. He didn't open up, you know, underneath the sink. Oh. He didn't see anything. You just don't know. But they're, like you said, there's so many different ways.
But at your house, Lisa, because your house is made of glass. Crystal, too. Yeah. You can see inside the walls, right?
Yes, you can. No,
exactly.
Now, as a realtor, I can tell you, you know, best practices. You know, each of us do our business the way we, you know, are intended to do. But yes. For me, I take more seriously with the fact of the mold. So the fact that the client is saying, is that mold Veronica? My immediate answer is, I'm not sure, I'm not a mold expert. However, since you bring that concern to the table, let's order a mold report, and that way you can get it out of the way before we close escrow. And if the buyer says, you know what, I'm not willing to go the extra mile for the extra expense, then I make them sign a waiver saying I was told to get a mold report certification and I declined. So again, the responsibility comes back on the professional to make sure that all the due diligence are done and all the inquiries and doubts of the buyer are satisfied before we close escrow.
So there you have it. Don't act against the advice of your broker.
Stay tuned. We'll be right back with some more real estate rants.
Real Estate Rant and AGR Realtors are proud supporters of Michael Aguilar and Associates, advocates for stroke awareness and integrative healthcare.
In February 2012, I suffered a stroke due to high blood pressure. I was rushed to the hospital where I was admitted for the next 30 days. I was initially told I may have to stay in the hospital for about 3 months, but I made rapid improvements in my recuperation and continued to improve to this day.
When Michael left the hospital, he did not have insurance to cover his rehabilitation, so he focused on integrative healthcare to get better. At the end of 2013, seeing a need for stroke awareness, Michael started his own company, Michael Aguilar & Associates, to focus on creating awareness about the dangers of high blood pressure and stroke.
If you would like more information, please call me at 562-464-7297, or you can visit my website at www.strokeawareness101.com.
Michael Aguilar & Associates, creating awareness and saving lives one person at a time.
Do we have your attention? When it comes to tequila, two things matter: heart and passion. Never compromising integrity for mass production. Number One Tequila delivers the goods. Taste the heart and passion of Mexico in every bottle. We make it right. We make it fun. Superior Tequila. There's only Number One. There's only Number One. There's only Number One.
Been in an accident? Then you need your vehicle professionally repaired. That's exactly what you get when you bring your vehicle to Greg's Auto Body Repair. Free quotes within minutes. We will provide everything you need for a hassle-free auto body repair, from an accurate estimate to working with your insurance company. We will get your vehicle to its pre-accident condition as soon as possible. Greg's Auto Body has been serving Los Angeles County and local cities since 1970. Call us at 562-789-1300.
A home is the biggest investment in most people's lives. Buying or selling should be a positive experience.
Whether you want to be a wealthy real estate investor or just trying to find a place to call home, at AJR & Associates, we focus on the client's needs.
We understand the market better than most. Let us bring the value to you and make the right choice.
AJR & Associates, making your dream house a reality. Call us today for a free consultation at 562-882-1976. Or you can log on to www.hgrrealtors.com.
With a track record of great results, bringing knowledge, wisdom, and expertise to you. Hablamos Español.
Thanks for tuning in to Real Estate Rant Radio.
Make sure to join us every Wednesday at 3:30 p.m. on the Rant Radio Network,
where we talk about solutions to your real estate problems.
We are back here at the Real Estate Rant, here at the towers of the Rant Radio Network. I'm your host, Mr. Alex Annalini, sent to my left here. I can't even say my last name. How do you like that?
I can't believe
to it. To my left, Miss Lisa Lombardi. How are you?
I'm doing great.
All right. And another shout out again for Mr. Lombardi. All of our prayers and wishes with you, my friend. And we hope for the best and hope you get better and hope to see you here soon.
Awesome.
All righty. Give us a call at 855-693-4897. Real Estate Rant and AJR & Associates are proud sponsors of Michael Aguilar & Associates. And Stroke Awareness, you can reach Michael at www.strokeawareness101.com, or you can email him at michaelpaguilar@hotmail.com. He had a stroke a few years ago, and he now does seminars and speeches on how not to have a stroke. So you can reach him. Again, the visual came up there for the phone number. You can reach him at that phone number and or email him or go on to his website. It's all good. In-house today, we have Mr. Kaya Redford and Miss Veronica Larrea. Did I say that right?
Close enough.
Yeah. Say it again for me. Just
Larrea.
Larrea.
You have to roll that R.
Did I say it right?
Yeah. Okay. Double R.
Because coming up on the next segment, I'm probably going to mess it up again. You know, I'm like that. What can I say? Anyway, global strategist and master real estate coaches in-house today. Excited to have you guys. Where can you go now to get this kind of information? And we've talked about NLP before. We had Ruben Mata on the show. Yes. He does NLP as well, and that was a great show. And I'm actually glad to have Kai and Veronica on the show today to talk more about it, because they have a little bit of a different message, but at the end of the day, it helps to understand what they have to say. So real quick, why don't we do the fun fact, Lisa?
Okay.
All right. And Mr. Patalones isn't in the booth, so we won't get the image up, but what is it anyways?
Okay. The Seattle Kingdom was so expensive that the building wasn't paid off until 2015, a full 15 years after it was what?
And it's the Kingdom.
Kingdom, sorry.
Yeah, Kingdom. You said Kingdom.
I don't know why I said Kingdom. Condom. So what? What is that?
Condom?
What? No, not condom.
That's what it said. It sounded like.
Oh, my God. No. So we can't really actually say anything right now. We just have to have someone call in.
Yeah. Give us a call, 855-693-4897. You can win that $25 gift card. You get the design deal of the day, or you happen to know what the fun fact has to say for us today. And when Mr. Patalones comes up, I'll have him put the visual up. I actually have a picture of this, of the Kingdom.
I said
it wrong.
I don't know why. I'm sorry. I apologize.
Kingdom.
Dome.
Okay.
Dome.
Kingdom being demolished.
Uh-huh.
We have a picture of it being demolished. Isn't that nuts? Anyway, so back to NLP. I'll give the floor over to you guys.
Yes.
I don't know. Who should we start with? Flip a coin. Kaya, you want to start? Okay.
Sure.
Kaya, give us a short background about yourself.
All right. Well, I'm excited to be here, really, with Lisa and yourself, and honored to be on this show, and excited to be here with my partner, Veronica Larrea. And a little bit about myself. I'm European. I was born in Omaha, Nebraska, but I grew up in Europe most of my childhood. And then I came back to the U.S. in my 20s, went to UCLA, found myself lost through many years of trying to discover who I was, what I was supposed to do with my life, my purpose, my direction. Stumbled upon at a networking party, some individual said, "Hey, you know, you've got something about you. You've got like an aura, something cool about you." And I said, "Really, do I?" Because I didn't see it. And they said, "Have you seen the movie The Secret?" And I said, "The Secret? What's The Secret?" Yeah, they said, "Oh, it's a DVD movie. You got to see The Secret. You got to see The Secret." So I went to another party. I'm like, I have no time to watch movies. I'm just busy trying to figure out stuff. I went to another event.
It's more five of a, events. It's more of a documentary, actually.
Yeah, yeah. Five events later, everybody's talking about The Secret, The Secret, The Secret. Eventually, wow. I'm just sick and tired of hearing what's The Secret. So I pop in this DVD. And before I popped in this DVD, I'd like to say first that I would consider myself at that time kind of like a lost soul. I didn't have any direction, as I mentioned before, no purpose, no. I was a person that believed success was people that were lucky. Literally, I was playing the lotto. I mean, I thought that the only way I would ever be able to get anything, buy anything, do anything, is to win the lotto. And I would look at people and that were successful, and I'm like, they were at the right place at the right time. It's just luck. It's just luck. So I pop in this DVD, and here's this tall, skinny, slender guy with white hair speaking to me in this DVD, who I later discovered was Bob Proctor. And he says, fellows, ladies and gentlemen, you create your experience of reality. You create it. It's not about luck. And I heard that and I said, well, this is some bullshit. this is a BS. I'm just trying to get lucky here. Yeah, yeah. What is this guy talking about? This is just not working for me. Secret, BS, secret, secret, right?
And this is all at the party now, or
this is when I watch. This is when I pop in the DVD, and I'm watching it, and then he continues to talk a little bit more, and I said, okay, let me just hear what other silly things this man has to say. He says, no, really. He says, you have a dream, whatever your dream is. You would not have that dream if you didn't have the capability of doing it. And again, I was wanting to dismiss everything he said. And at the same time, there was something happening. By the way, up until this point, I had never had a breakthrough. I did not even know what a breakthrough was. I've come to realize a breakthrough is an aha moment, an epiphany, a realization. As I'm hearing this, I'm having this funny feeling in my chest, can't explain it. My hair is standing on end. I've got goosebumps around my body. I'm thinking, what the heck just came in the room? What's going on? I'm having a breakthrough. I didn't even know what it was. Short story after, I had a breakthrough. I had this moment where I realized that we create our experience of reality. We create our results. We own our destiny. Didn't know that until I was about 33 years old. Ended up meeting Bob Proctor. Said to him, I'm going to work with you. I'm going to figure this out. Ended up working with him, Michael Beck with Jack Canfield. That's kind of how I started out in the early days. Went through this journey of discovery. One day I'm hosting an event. Ryan Seacrest was announcing it for us on the radio that Bob Proctor was coming in town, was being hosted by Kaya Redford. A lot of things that I had absolutely no idea that I would ever be able to do. I was in that moment about to get up on stage with him to speak alongside the guy that had given me the breakthrough on the DVD only 4 months prior. It was really bizarre. And I had all this fear and this stuff that came up, which is going to be a little bit about what today is about as well, right? This fear and this stuff came up, and I realized there's got to be something more. There's got to be something deeper, which is how I eventually stumbled upon NLP. Because this woman, a trainer, came in the room, another event that I hosted. She came in the room, and she was speaking, and she says, you create your experience of reality. She also said that your conscious mind, our thinking mind, the thinking mind where we come up with our goals, our dreams, and our desires, has to be aligned, congruent with our unconscious mind. And I'm looking at her now, I'm going, what the heck is this woman talking about? What's the conscious mind, the unconscious mind? I don't even know. What is all this foo-foo weird stuff anyway, right?
Well that was going to be one of my questions. Now, what is NLP? You mentioned that a couple times.
Yeah, yeah. So she's telling me this, and I'm getting to NLP in a second. She says, you got to be congruent. And I'm like, what does congruent mean? She says, if what your goals, dreams, and desires are that you think of, if it's not matching at the unconscious level or the subconscious level, your blueprints, your print, your programming from childhood of what you believed growing up that you were capable of, your values, your emotions, your beliefs, all of that, you're not going to get there. She said, you're not going to get there. You'll do something called two steps forward, one step back, which is called what? Sabotage. And as this woman was saying this, I'm like, oh my gosh, this is me. I'm sabotaging. I keep sabotaging. I want to do something, but I have fear. I want to do something else and I hesitate and I procrastinate. I'm so much more. And then, and she continued to talk and I realized she was talking about NLP, neuro-linguistic programming, which I then discovered there is a science to success. There's a science. It's called the study of human excellence. It's been studied by Ronald Reagan, Bill Clinton, Oprah Winfrey, Richard Branson. All these people have studied it for 20, 30 years. And here I am, 33, trying to figure out what my purpose in life is. And I had no idea that there was a solution out there to help me find my way. So that's kind of how I stumbled upon and got involved with NLP. And then the rest is kind of history. Then, you know, everybody's enjoying it, loving it. Growing a lot from it, achieving outstanding results in real estate and financial services and just across all different industries. And I know that's one of the topics we're going to talk about today.
Kaya, though, I would think that a lot of people think exactly the way you thought when you're at, you know, when you were at 33, like it's luck, you know, how people become successful or they were born into it or whatever it might be. I think that sometimes people think, that's just lucky, like you said, they were there at the right time at the right place or they knew someone. And it's pretty interesting how you say it, is that you definitely, I have something on my mirror, is that you create your own life. You do create it.
Absolutely.
Yep. Yeah,
my dad used the definition of luck as being preparation meets opportunity.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, so in essence, it's kind of the same thing. I mean, we can use that word very superfluously, luck. I mean, yep. It's kind of thrown it out there. A lot of us have a certain understanding of what that means. Mm-hmm. But I guess, in essence, what you're saying is that we create our own luck.
Absolutely. And yes. I thought luck was something that was going to be handed to me. You know, I don't want to get like strange here, but I'm just going to be honest. I used to dream of someone coming into my life and saying, you. And I would go, who? You. And who? Me? You? Yeah, you. Wake up. I was waiting for someone to come. And I even had an image of with this guy. You know how they knight the knights, you know, with around the round table a sword. You're now a knight. I was waiting for someone to say, you're now a knight. You can now do some great things with your life. And I was waiting for this person. And ironically, I even had a description of what this man looked like. Looked like Danny DeVito. Some unassuming guy, funny guy. One day would just walk up to me and go, you. And I would go, who? You, wake up. And then, you know, I realized through this whole process that I was supposed to just wake up myself. That was just an image that, because I felt like someone had to wake me up, that I couldn't wake myself up. It was almost like Sleeping Beauty, right? The idea that I'm just in a dream of you know, I'm just asleep for years and years, and I've got to wait for Prince Charming to wake me up.
Well, we're going to hold that thought, Kaya, and we're going to be right back, and we'll be hearing from Veronica. Stay tuned. We'll be right back with some more Real Estate Rants.
It's one thing to own a business, it's another to promote it. That's why thousands of business owners rely on Monster Marketing Group. Design, print, mail, custom mailers, all for as little as 29 cents delivered. That includes postage. Send to a neighborhood, zip code, or an entire city. With just a simple call, 888-49-MONSTER, you can easily promote your business, sales, events, grand openings, send coupons, and much more.
Your mail delivers in as little as 5 days. No dealing with the mailing list or paperwork. Monster Marketing does all the heavy lifting. Get started now by calling 888-49-MONSTER or go to monsterng.com.
Monster Marketing Group. We deliver. We give you results. We can prove it.
Real Estate Rant and AGR Realtors are proud supporters of Michael Aguilar and Associates, advocates for stroke awareness and integrative health care.
In February 2012, I suffered a stroke due to high blood pressure. I was rushed to the hospital where I was admitted for the next 30 days. I was initially told I may have to stay in the hospital for about 3 months, but I made rapid improvements in my recuperation and continue to improve to this day.
When Michael left the hospital, he did not have insurance to cover his rehabilitation, so he focused on integrative healthcare to get better. At the end of 2013, seeing a need for stroke awareness, Michael started his own company, Michael Aguilar and Associates.
to focus on creating awareness about the dangers of high blood pressure and stroke.
If you would like more information, please call me at 562-464-7297, or you can visit my website at www.strokeawareness101.com.
Michael Aguilar and Associates, creating awareness and saving lives one person at a time.
Experts know that for pastry, Baker's Bodega has it all. Exclusive brands like Westco Bank Mart, Satin Ice, and Pastry Pride. One-on-one day seminars for cake decorating and gelatin art. So for our service, wide range of ingredients and supplies, and for the low prices, Baker's Bodega has it all. But you don't need to be an expert. Baker's Bodega, 7869 Paramount Boulevard in Pico Rivera. Come, we're waiting for you.
It's hot out here. I need a drink.
Have a mucho macho michelada.
What's a michelada?
Michelada is a Mexican Bloody Mary made with beer. All you have to do is get bucket-sized michelada, open it up, pour it in your favorite beer, and you're good.
What if you don't like beer?
You can use it in lemon-lime soda, vodka with lime, or tequila with lemon-lime soda.
Sounds delicious.
Where do you find it? You can find it at your favorite store, or you can go to muchomachomichelada.com.
Find us on Twitter and Facebook.
Thanks for tuning in to Real Estate Rant Radio.
Make sure to join us every Wednesday at 3:30 p.m. on the Rant Radio Network,
where we talk about solutions to your real estate problems.
And we are back here at the Real Estate Rant, and we're having a drum session here at the Rant Radio Network. Give us a call at 855-693-4897. I'm your host, Mr. Alex Alanis. And to my left here, Miss Lisa Lombardi. Where else are you going to get this kind of information? You can give us a call and tell us about your problems in real estate. Rant about your problems in real estate. Have a question for myself, Lisa, Kaya, or Veronica. You can call us at that number and win a $25 gift card. You can also win that gift card if you get this particular design, Mr. Pantalones, if you please. We also want to mention the fun fact. Why don't we do that again?
You know what, though? You gave out the answer.
Of what?
Of the fun fact.
I did? What was the answer?
You did.
But then that means someone had to really
pay attention
to every single word.
That's okay.
Well, let's read it again. Can we put the visual up, Mr. Pantalones?
Yeah.
The kingdom.
I thought you were talking about this one.
Yeah. What did I give? Did I give out
the answer? You did. But it's okay. People have to really pay attention now, don't they?
Yeah. Well, this was interesting. I found this on Facebook and I go, man, I got to post this up. Joel Epstein be like, don't it make you feel good to give a little money to God?
Oh my gosh.
That's his house. How do you like that?
It is what it is.
He's dialed in, isn't he? NLP?
There's
the kingdom. What was the question again, Lise? So I gave away the answer to this
Yes, you did. You did.
Oh, you know what? Now that I see it, you're right. Well, let's see. Let's see if anybody calls in.
Let's see if anybody was present.
Yeah, let's see if anybody wants that $24 gift card.
Is anybody calling us over there?
No, he doesn't pay attention back there anyway.
I know. The Seattle Kingdom. Gosh,
kingdom.
Dumb. God, I'm like out of it. Was so expensive that the building wasn't paid off until 2015, with a full 15 years after it was. Oh, wow. What?
All
it's right there.
Give us a call at 556-934-897. You can win that $25 gift card. So
the dome.
We had an opportunity to hear from Kaya. Mr. Kaya Redford, Master Certified Global Strategist and Master Real Estate Coach, along with Veronica Larrea.
Yes.
Did I say that correctly?
Absolutely.
Oh, look, I got it right. Okay, so they are here helping us understand NLP and also helping us understand that success is, how did you say it, Kai? It was a roadmap?
Yeah, and it's really the study of human excellence. Success is really being able to align our goals, dreams, and our desires with our behavior and our emotions. Being congruent.
Mr. Pantalones, are we picking up Kaya? I'm not getting him here in my headset. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt. It's just I want to make sure you're being heard.
Sure.
All right, so we got a thumbs up back there. So Miss Veronica, so short introduction about yourself.
you know, I came to this country when I was 16 years old. I came to discover a new family with my mom. I was born and raised in Ecuador by my father. So just like you, I was very, very attached, beyond attached to my father, because, you know, he was the only mother and father figure, including a coach at the same time. So I came here, I was 16, and I came to learn a new culture, you know, how the Americanized children behave at school. It was just such a good experience for me. I was a lot of discovery for myself. And then through that, through there, because I was very passionate about real estate since the beginning, back in Ecuador, I went into the residential land development. So I was blessed. I was going to say lucky, but it's actually blessed that I got a mentor to take me under his wing and said, Veronica, you know, I noticed that you have certain talents and gifts. Let's go ahead and enhance those. Come and work with me. And we went and developed through California Community Builders and all developer Moore Park, the city of Moore Park. And by the time I was 22, I have delivered already keys to homeowners, about 1,600 of them, as a developer. From there, the rest of 20 years after that, it was being nothing but residential and commercial land development. And then I went into the retail business of real estate because of my, at the time, he was 17-year-old Jimmy. You met him, right,
yeah.
Lisa?
Yeah.
And he said, you know, I would love to join the force, Mom. You know, I'm going to become a real estate professional. So my heart skipped a beat. And I said, oh my gosh, you know, I see my son in the real estate industry, of course, but I see him as a top producer, a leader in the industry. So I did what any leader mother will do. I retired from residential and commercial land development, and I became a realtor in 2008 during the collapse of the market, against everybody's advice, including my coaches, that the sky is falling and I should remain in the residential development. So I did not listen, which I always not listen. It always pays off when you don't listen to other people's opinions. And I went to retail. And Jimmy and I became top producers in the down market. You know, we landed an REO account, but we did not become top producers because of the REO account. We became top producers because we managed to do short sales pretty much just like REO accounts in bulk. And it wasn't about loan modifications. We didn't believe in loan modifications. You know, I have a couple of degrees under my belt, including, you know, forensic accounting, financial, and also strategy. So based on that, all the families that came into our pipeline, what I call it, they were financially unstable. So there was no way retaining a loan with that type of mortgage was sustainable for the family. So needless to say, the subprime came and went, and now we're in the new market. And it's just a beautiful career that I have learned through so many years, and not by myself. Absolutely, I have mirrored the best, the cream of the crop of our industry. One of my idols is Mary Rodriguez, Center 21 Mary Rodriguez. I also admire Nahid Benyamin. She is a top producer. She devotes herself to buyers. And listing agents, there's so many that I could just name a few. And I don't want to offend my friends because they're my best friends and allies, right? But I have mirrored every single behavior that they have done. And that's what I didn't know, was that I was doing actually NLP processes without knowing. I came into the NLP world because, like everybody else, I wanted to take my production to the next level. What I didn't expect, that it was going to change my life forever. And one of our coaches in our academy, his name is Dan Mendelo. He couldn't put it in any better words. He said, NLP is us. It's actually our humanity. Is our gifts and talents that we were given when we were born. Now, what happens with humans, we get interrupted by all these things in life. You know, we run our life pretty much with routine. We do this. We don't pay attention to certain things. And we really do not pay attention, some of us, to ourselves. We are so focused to take care of others that in between, we miss the boat for ourselves. So my experience through NLP is bringing back the greatness, you know, that I have inside me as a mentor coach, not only in the real estate arena, but the reason what I wanted to study transformation, how can I help somebody else transform, not from here to 6 months or a year, but actually within minutes. So, but the processes that we have in our academy are so extraordinary. For example, there's one process that someone can have fear or anger for 35 years, has been carried this anger for whatever reason. and the record that we have in our academy, Kaya did the process in our classroom, and it was in 3.5 minutes. It disappears completely. And it's not, you know, some people might say, well, you know, that's just not real. It is real. It is real because some of the processes I have done in myself, on some of the things that I have worked on myself. And being a nurturer, a mother, a protector, sometimes we kind of overdo things for our children. And that was one of my breakthroughs. It was time for me to allow my children, my cubs, the big ones. I do mentor and coach teenagers, if you want to call them, young adults between 18 to 32 years old. And that to me, it's a gift that I was given. And I'm a sole supporter of the, you know, gay community. And I have seen how they blossom. They come with their mindset of, I'm not accepted, I'm not loved, I'm rejected. And the transformation happens within a couple of days after we do processes, and then they carry on as they should with a mentality of equality and acceptance and self-love, most importantly, self-acceptance. So to me, my experience of NLP has been in the heart. And remember, I mentioned that I wanted to take my business to the next level. That was my intention initially. Why? Because I wasn't fully awakened. My focus was outward. It was, let me go get more market share. Let me be an even bigger top producer. Let me get all these shiny things and accumulate all this stuff. Then I realized, been there, done that, had it, and it's still missing. There's something missing.
There's something missing, absolutely.
Now, when I come from contribution in the classroom, the emotions that I feel when someone in front of me, whether it's older than me or younger than me, and they discover truly who they are right then and then in front of you, when you see the spark or the tears, sometimes we have students that cry because it's been so emotionally involved with that particular matter.
Now this is kind of moving forward a little bit to what you're doing now, right? In terms of, because you mentioned now like a classroom setting.
Yes.
So you guys are going in and you're coaching other people. And this is not just real estate agents, right?
It's not necessarily real estate. Our classrooms are so beautifully put together. We have C-level managers, CEOs, managers. Then the second tier, we have sales reps. We have real estate professionals, insurance people. We have wives that come and support the realtors. So when you come into our classrooms, not only you're learning from the NLP techniques, but you will learn life between each other. That's how they do it.
So can success be researched or studied? I mean, is that something, because you're talking about it like it's something tangible.
But
I think everybody's kind of looking for it, you know.
You know what it is? In our world, you know? In the context of real estate, and I'm just going to be blunt, you know, in the context of real estate, we're always chasing the magic pill that will avoid us prospecting. We're always trying to...
How do we lose weight, right?
Oh, I'm glad you mentioned that. You know, in our academy, we do have a program called Lose Weight at Will. And it's headed by one of our amazing coaches, Dan Mandelo. He is a trainer's trainer as well, NLP certified. And he has this amazing two-class program where you come in and there's no diets. There's no powders, there's no magic pills to lose. It's just an understanding of who you are, your mindset, and what are the reasons that we eat what we eat. And Kaya and I have gone through it. I mean, I'm not going to boost my, you know.
I lost 16 pounds. Hello.
I lost 85. So
wow, congratulations.
So because we are coming up on the break, I just wanted to do the movie pick of the week. Disney's Inside Out. It kind of goes along with what you were saying.
Stay tuned. Stay tuned. We'll be right back with some more real estate rants.
Looking for a delicious, fresh family meal that's ready when you are and easy on your budget? Welcome to Piara Pizza. We make our pizzas with handmade dough, 100% real cheese, and tomato sauce blended with our own spices. Nothing is ever frozen. We always have large pepperoni and cheese pizzas fresh and waiting for you for only $5. Or choose one of our specialty pizzas. We have veggie, meat lovers, supreme, and Hawaiian. Add an order of our amazing hot wings, cheesy bread, or breadsticks. Our locations are ultra-modern, ultra-clean, and open 7 days a week. Visit any one of our locations today. Or check us out on the web at www.piarapizza.com. Piara Pizza. Fresh, hot, and ready for you when you come in. Stop in for your Piara Pizza today.
ProTech Carpet Tile and Care provides professional cleaning services for carpet, tile, grout, upholstery, and fine area rugs.
ProTech technicians are professionally trained and certified cleaning and restoration experts.
We specialize in restoring damage caused by heavy soil and odor.
We can remove challenging spots such as coffee, tea, ink, gum, wine, and many more.
We have saved our customers thousands of dollars on new flooring and furniture expenses with our advanced cleaning processes.
Call for a free estimate at 562-447-4300 and visit us on our website, www.myprotechsite.com.
Hey, this is Joe Perez, owner at ProTech. Just reminding you that ProTech Carpet and Tile Care is your professional choice.
Business that needs to get noticed? Your ideas need a great website. And at Infuse, we build simple, clean, and efficient websites. We believe that even the wildest ideas should come to life in a beautiful way. We build responsive sites, e-commerce sites, and even help with business email setup and search engine optimization. Every great idea needs a great website. Start your new look today. Check us out at www.infuse.com. That's www.enfuse.com. Or call us at 800-542-4783. Again, that's 800-542-4783. Infuse, we get it done.
Located in Monrovia, California, Mount Sierra College prepares highly skilled graduates for careers in management, information technology, media arts, and game arts. Transfer earned credits or start right after high school and earn a bachelor's degree in 4 years or less. Combine industry-driven, hands-on small classes with your general education units. Mount Sierra College. Invest in yourself. Financial aid is available for those who qualify.
Thanks for tuning in to Real Estate Rant Radio.
Make sure to join us every Wednesday at 3:30 p.m. on the Rant Radio Network,
where we talk about solutions to your real estate problems.
We are back here at the Real Estate Rant, here at the towers of the Rant Radio Network. I'm your host, Mr. Alex Alanese. To my left, Ms. Lisa Lombardi. In-house today, we have Mr. Kaya Redford, Master Certified Trainer and NLP. I was going to say linguistics, but that just doesn't sound right. Success coach.
Yes.
Right? And Veronica Larrea.
Yes.
Got it. Okay. And global strategist. I love that title. You guys globally, and we're not talking about the world, right? We're talking about in terms of your feelings, in terms of how you neurologically process things. Is that, yeah. That's what, yes, you mean by global, right? Global, right, strategist.
Well, global, you know, really talks about many things. So global as in global transformation,
okay,
first,
nice,
and foremost.
Okay. All right.
So global transformation, I think, you know, many of us would probably agree that there's a lot of crazy things going on in the world. Yes?
Absolutely.
9/11 happens and then we get off track and now there's a lot of conflict in the world. I have people on my Facebook newsfeed whenever I'm looking at it once in a while, and I see these videos, and I purposefully do not delete some of the crazy things going on in the world that come on the newsfeed that people videotape. I don't delete. If I wasn't a coach, I would delete them because I wouldn't want to see it. But me as a coach with a responsibility that I feel I have with Veronica, with our whole team of coaches, we have about 15 coaches. We feel like we have a responsibility to transform the world, change the world. So we have a program called Conflict Resolution, which we bring to major Fortune 500 companies. We're looking to bring it to, you know, we've been working with Bank of America already, New York Life, Century 21, Keller Williams, Xerox, Remax, all these different companies with success, or the study of human excellence, or higher productivity, or conflict resolution. We also work with the mayor of Ontario, Paul Lyon, nice, on city organizations with conflict resolution. The conflict resolution really has to do with racial discrimination, sexual harassment, workplace rage, anger, jealousy, hatred, all that stuff. It's really all that dark stuff that's not really who we are. It's really not who we are as a humanity. So in that program, we focus on helping people honor and respect each other and resolve and get rid of conflicts and to come together as one. You know, we really do believe we are one. Some people forget that they're one. They feel like this other person is different than them, you know, because they have a different belief or a different religion, that they're different than them. And they think that that qualifies them or gives them a right to go to that country and hurt and maim that person because they have a different belief. Mm. We're for everybody. You know, we really believe everybody's our brother or sister. And how do we teach this? How do we bring the world together? We're really one.
So global has a multiple meaning in that case.
And then top of that.
Mr. Petalones, if we can throw their website banner up real quick, you can actually reach Veronica and Kaya at their website, www.krsuccess.com. And Mr. Petalones will put that up in a second. You can also reach Kaya at 626-329-8001, or you can reach Veronica at 951-378-3406. And the information will come up on the screen as well. If you remember the date, October 21st, 2015, you can also access that on YouTube. It will be burned there in through eternity, right, Miss Lisa?
I like that.
Where else are you going to get this kind of information? Where else are you going to get this kind of help? Kaya and Veronica are experts in this field, and they would like to help others in strategizing those things now with what we've been talking about.
Yes.
Just kind of delving in a little bit. There are three components. Go ahead, Lisa.
I wanted to say something. What do you think most people, I mean, how they block themselves from success? I mean, do you think it's just they have this mindset that, you know how I grew up, or, mm-hmm. you know, it's the way I look, or
are we doing you, Lisa?
No, I'm just saying.
Kaya, would you like to delve into Lisa's?
I mean, because a lot of people, you know.
Let me bring the couch out.
Because I think as me as a title rep, you know, me going out and seeing realtors, you know, you see that it's so funny, like, there's some people that just started in the business, and I see them just go.
Yeah.
You know, and some that have been in the business for 5 or 10 years, and they're still struggling, you know?
So what this comes to me to really look at is the programming. So basically, about a good 50% of our personality is already formed by the age 8. You know, our thoughts, our beliefs, whether I'm good enough, I'm not good enough, whether I can be a top producer, whether I can't be a top producer. By the time we're 12, 14, and even 18, we're about 85, 90%. Programmed the way we think. So people that come into the business and achieve great success are usually wired from an early age to have abundance mindset or success mindset. Most people that were taught success were taught by someone who probably wasn't successful. If we look at the, you know, Veronica and I, we go into these offices and we ask them all the time, how many of us are top producers? One or two hands go up out of, you know, say less than 3% of the hands go up. And the question is, why are no more hands going up than just 2 to 3%? Why do they believe they're not top producers? I say to them, if this was my first day in real estate and a coach got up in front of the room and I had not done one transaction and someone asked me, am I a top producer? You better believe my hand would be up, because I know that what my thoughts are, things, my mindset, you know, this, we're leaning over a table right now. This table was an idea. This microphone was an idea in someone's mind. Then it was created. We've got to have the mindset that I am first. I am a top producer. Then the behavior. Most people have been trained and raised in a family, given advice, just like Veronica was saying, given advice from people who never figured out the secrets to success. And these are the people saying, this is what you should do. Coming from a person who showed absolutely no knowledge of success, grew up unhappy, unsuccessful, struggled, and yet these are the people giving us advice. It reminds me of the story when we talk about Marilyn Savant. And most people haven't heard of the name Marilyn Savant, but she's the person with the highest recorded IQ in history. And she was asked, okay, you're the woman with the highest recorded IQ in history. Can you meet someone, look at someone, and in a matter of a minute or so, figure out where they're going to be in 10 years from now? She said, absolutely. All I have to do is ask 2 questions. Exactly.
Shall we?
Shall we? First question is, who do you surround yourself with? Who are the 5 people you spend most of your time with? She said, your results will be directly proportionate to the average of the five people. So if you grew up and spent all your time around these five individuals and their mindsets, their success level was not there. They struggled, they had pain, they were frustrated, they had all this stuff going on. And if you continue to associate with people of that mindset, their energy rubs off on you, their thoughts become your thoughts. You create the results that's a reflection of the average of their results. So she said, you've got to upgrade your circle of influence. So this, you talked about success. Why do some people come in the business and they're successful right away? Why do other people come in the business and they struggle? Because it doesn't matter if the best coach and the best system is right in front of them saying, these are what you need to do. If the person has this programming that they don't believe that they're a top producer, they don't believe they're good enough, or they don't believe that they've never seen anybody make that kind of money, they don't even believe in themselves as capable of doing it, they're not going to do it. They're going to do a thing called sabotage. Take two steps forward, one step back. Getting to what Veronica was saying, it's about prospecting. So let's dive in. Let's be very specific. How does this show up? Okay, real estate. We go into offices all the time. How many of you top producers? Two or three hands show up, go up. Everybody else's hands down. We ask, how many of you did your 200 door knocks or your 200 phone calls or your 300 phone calls yesterday or the day before? Very few people are doing it. You know, so the woman's right in front of me and I say, how many calls did you make yesterday? She goes, zero. Well, you're in sales, right? Yes. How many calls did you make the day before? She thinks about it, rolls her eyes, and she goes, I think one. How many calls did you make the day before? I had this going on, that going on, zero. So how many calls did you make in the last week? Five. Well, so you basically are in a business where it's 80% prospecting or more, and you just haven't done what you need to do. So why is that? So there's other things like fear. Like people have a fear of rejection, fear of picking up the phone, fear of hearing the no. You know, there's so many issues that and challenges that certain people have in their psyche that prevents them from success. And then you have these outstanding top producers that make it look easy. You know, Veronica's son, Jimmy, right now is doing amazing. And he's just killing it out there, right? So, and he is very focused on what he does. She tells me all the time, you know, you can't bother him. You know, when he's in his business mode, you go into his office and you want to bother him with something while he's in prospecting mode. He has his earphones on. He doesn't hear you. He's there. Right? So people know what to do. They know they need to prospect. They know they need to go out and build outstanding success, but they don't do what they know. Why? Because there is these things, blocks at an unconscious level or subconscious level that maybe they don't feel they deserve it enough. They're not good enough, or they don't have the mindset that they can ever be.
Right. And sounds like what you and Veronica are both saying is that you have to get into your subconscious. I mean, because in your conscious level, you're saying one thing, and then in your subconscious, once you get into your subconscious, it really relates. I mean, because I think when you get into your subconscious, you're getting into a deeper.
Absolutely. Like an example is, you know, when I was managing a group of agents, they'll go through this every single day. Part of me wants to be at 7:30 role playing with Veronica. And part of me, eventually I'll be in the office. So some of my agents will come in around 10 or 11 a.m.
Right.
Yeah. Well, get what happens. The momentum has gone and passed. They miss the role play. So they come into the office with good intention, but poor execution. So they show up and now they're clueless. And then they sit in their desks and then now they feel uncomfortable.
We had David Plummer on the show and he was talking about that. He's actually a real estate coach. You know, he does some things on real estate.
No, he does title too.
He calls it GP3, right? And he talked about the individuals that, it's funny how people call me during the show. Yeah, they know I'm doing the show. he talked about the individuals that maybe shouldn't be in the business, you know?
Yes. And that's one of the things that our academy brings into the classroom, where we see the student that says, you know, I've been in the sales force for about 3 years and I have had this amount of success, very little, not as much as my other partner who just came in 2 months ago and he's off the charts. So we do a little bit of assessment, what's going on, and then we figure out together if sales is the right career and path for them to do it. For me, I'm passionate because, should I continue?
Unfortunately, we're definitely going to have to bring you guys back in again.
Thank
because
you so much.
Thank you so much for coming in.
Again, we have an event, too.
Oh, right.
Coming up December. Yes, December 4, 5, 6 in Los Angeles, which is a Friday, Saturday, Sunday. We have an amazing event called Success NLP. Sales and Leadership Mastery. It's a 3-day event.
Rangers,
and you can get a buy one, get one. So you call us in at our number, which is area code 626-329-8001. Again, 626-329-8001. And mention the Rant Radio Network, and we will give you a special promotion that's only going to be for a very short period of time, which is you can buy one and get one free.
All right. Well, thank you so much for joining us. And coming up at 5 o'clock today, the Three Guys Rant. Thank you for joining us here every Wednesday at 3 o'clock for the Real Estate Rant.
Thank you.